And then as soon as you park your ass on that chair with your hostess, you're on the fucking clock.
I-N-D-E-P-E-N-D-E-N-T, can you spell it? Modern women need a man just like a fish needs a necklace. I don't need your permission to be sexy and happy, cause I make my own sugar and I am my own daddy. Let's go. You wanted a ball till your balls got busted. It said you like my confidence, but do you now? Every time I talk, you gotta interrupt it. Oops, was it uncool of me to think out loud? Don't make this complicated, or you'll never see me naked. I-N-D-E-P-E-N-D-E-N-T, can you spell it? Modern women need a man just like a fish needs a necklace. I don't need your permission to be sexy and happy, cause I make my own sugar and I am my own daddy. Let's go. I am my own daddy. I can take a joke if it's a joke that's funny. You're not that funny. Now you call me sensitive and say that it's a free country. It's a free country. I can get along with almost anybody. Until you run your mouth around and round and round and round. Don't make this complicated, or you'll never see me naked. I-N-D-E-P-E-N-D-E-N-T, can you spell it? Modern women need a man just like a fish needs a necklace. I don't need your permission to be sexy and happy, cause I make my own sugar and I am my own daddy. Let's go.
There are some stories in Japan that just warm the cockles of your heart, that make you feel, I wouldn't say good about yourself, but make you feel just above people. And stories like that, that you find funny and you find amusing, especially when you're from the north of England, usually involve people ruining their lives. So today, here's one of them stories. Right, I have been sitting on this story for a while. I first heard of this in April of this year. And it was a story coming out of Nagoya. I was aware of it, and then I completely forgot about it. And it raised its head again, maybe end of last week. What happened was, there was a woman who went under the pseudonym of Itadaki Joshi Riri-chan, which means sugar baby. Sugar baby Riri. So you can pretty much tell why she's got herself into trouble just by a stage name and just by, you know, her business. So what happened in April? She were charged with just swindling money out of fellas at the hostess bar. Now, for them of you not in the know, a hostess bar in Japan, they're for men and women. So if you're a fella like me, and I am telling you about a hostess bar, I've had no experience of them, but I'm going on what I've seen in documentaries, and I'm going on what some of my Japanese salarymen friends have told me. I live in a country of very, very shy people, men and women. To pick up women, to pick up men, especially in the 90s when I were coming up, you'd go to a pub, you'd have a few pints, you'd go to a nightclub, you'd see a woman that you liked, you'd start talking to her, have a dance, buy a drink, meet again a week later, third date, jackpot. And that is how you would pick up a woman, or you'd go out and pick up a fella. That's how it was. Now here, they don't do that. When people go out here, they go out with their own friends, they eat, and they go and have a drink. So it's very difficult to meet up with men and women to find your future partner. So these hostess bars pop up all over these major cities. So what you do is, after an hard day at work, a salaryman will go to one of these hostess bars, he'll pick his host from a menu, and then as soon as you park your ass on that chair with your hostess, you're on the fucking clock. Now, this hostess woman, God bless her, have got to put up with listening to the problems of these older fellas. Problems they've had at work, this, that, and the other. But what the hostesses have got to do is keep them there. If the longer they keep them there, the longer they keep them there drinking, the more money they're going to make for themselves and they're going to make for the club. Now, at the end of the month, all the money is totted up and the girls have a ranking. If you're at the top of that ranking, you get the bigger bonuses. Obviously, you've made the most money, but if you're at the top of that ranking, you get the bigger bonuses. And that's how it works. And you can make a fucking fortune. I knew a woman that came here during the bubble economy. She was a foreigner from Bradford. She was a white woman from Bradford. So, I mean, she was a Bradford 9, but a Bradford 9 is a fucking world 6. But she came here and she worked in these clubs for 6 months and went back home and bought a couple of houses. That's how much money you can make. This woman was top of her ranking. Now, she was doing this for 2 years and she had it down to a science. She had three fellas on the hook in these hostess bars. She'd got three of them on the hook. And within 6 months, you think 6 months, she swindled these three. Well, not, see, I don't see it as swindling and I can't understand why she's been put in prison. I can't understand why she's been sent down. The reason it's come back into the news is she was sentenced to 9 years. She was sentenced to 9 years in prison. She's gone back to court and appealed and she's got 6 months knocked off. So she's got to put in 8.5 years now. And she's only 26. So in 6 months, she got 155 million yen out of these three fellas in the 50s. Now, 155 million yen in today's money is, in today's exchange rate is £806,000 and $1,076,000. Now, she did that in 6 months. From three fellas. I wouldn't be putting this woman in prison. I'd be getting her on the fucking board of my company. To be able to get $1 million out of three fellas in 6 months doesn't deserve a prison sentence. It deserves a fucking round of applause. This woman has gone out of her way and she's got herself, she's turned herself into a millionaire in 6 months. How has she been here to do this? It starts off, she were giving the sob story out to judge and court. And I think it's the first time in her life it's not worked. It's not worked like it worked on these fellas in clubs. So what she was saying is she had no self-confidence, no self-esteem. She was bullied at school. And then she met up with this fella in Nagoya. And he said to her, come up to Tokyo and I'll get you into the hostess bars in Tokyo. So this fella took her up there, got her in the baths, and she were earning all right. But the fella were sort of nudging her, and he's saying, you know, you've got to give these fellas a sob story, and then you'll get more money out of them. And what I need to do is I need to get myself up the rankings. So she'd got herself in with this hostess fella, because the fellas have these hostess bars as well, where women come and spend time with fellas. And he wanted to get to the top of his ranking. So to do that, he were getting her to get money out of these fellas. He were then putting the money into his account at the club, and it were moving him up the rankings. So he were using her. Now, he got her into one of these places called a fuzuku. Now, a fuzuku is, it's a hostess bar, but you can get the, you can get your joint worked as well. You can get an hand job. So it's a sex place. Not only you can go in there, these women will listen to your sob stories, you'll have a drink with them, and then they'll take you in a back room and bang you. It sounds so fucking depressing. Anyway, I've seen her, and it's not the sort of thing I'd go for, but I can understand how the middle-aged men of Japan would go for her. She's got this cutesy look to her. She's got dyed blonde hair. You know, the makeup's making her look younger than what she is. And that's what fellas go for here. It's not a Westerner's bag. They love that high school, innocent look here in Japan. Whereas I would just prefer three fire-breathing fucking hookers from Moldova or Romania. Yeah, that's right. Not, I wouldn't go for anything like this in a month of Sundays. But the fellas of Japan go for it, and she knows this. She knows this, so she's dressed herself up in these cutesy stuff. She, with the advice of this fella, she's gone in there. She's got these three fellas on the hook, and then she just starts saying, You know, I need the money. I need to get away from my parents. My parents are causing me all sorts of grief. And then another fella, she was saying, you know, I've got a skin problem. I need to go to a clinic, but I can't afford it. And then another fella, she was telling, oh, I've got to get away from me ex-boyfriend in Nagoya. He won't leave me alone. He's stalking me. So she was saying in one night in this club, she made herself 27 million yen. So 27 million yen, just to put that into context, 816. So she's made herself £25,000. £25,000 in a night in a hostess bar. Now, I don't know if she's grabbing dick for that, but if she's got a table full of fellas and she's holding court, and that brandy and that whiskey's getting poured, it's going to be easy to rack up that money. It really is going to be easy to rack up that money. And she has done. Now, she got 155 million yen. $1 million. $1 million over the space of 2 years. And what she's done, instead of getting it back at Farah or buying herself an house or in investing it in something, she's given it all to this fucking nomark that worked at this host bar so he can get himself to the top of the ranking. You'd think, if it were me and I'd got this below average intelligence woman making me fucking millions and millions of yen every day, I would keep it on the lowdown. I wouldn't be telling a fucking soul about it. I would be keeping it to myself. This dick is on fucking YouTube bragging. He's got 19 million yen lined up in front of him. And he's saying, see what this bitch has just dropped off? She's just dropped me off 19.7 million yen in one night. And she's just given it to me. She wants me to be the number one host in this bar. What a dumb fuck. Anyway, he's been collared for that as well. So he's up in court. Now, she got charged. She's had to pay 8 million yen of her own money back, which she says she hasn't got 1 yen left. She says she's spent it all. She's spent a lot. Yeah, right. The fella who took the money from her, he's up in court. He's got to pay back 18 million yen. But then that's only 26. That's only 26 of the 155. So you're still left with 120 million that's unaccounted for. So God knows where that's gone. God knows where that's gone. Now, I'm not sure if this fella who got hold of most of the money, if he's going to go down. But she has just been given 8 years. 8 years. And the judge, after paying back that 8 million, as the judge sent her down, and I quote, he said, "I would like you to think again how to compensate the victims in the future. I would like you to think again how to compensate your victims in the future." That's just how polite Japan is. I would love it if... Can you imagine a hooker from Bradford who swindled some fucking 80-year-old out of his pension and his house? You know, she's sold the family's silver and she's up there in dock. And instead of the judge saying, "You're fucking paying him back," the judge says to this fucking methed out hooker, "You know, I'd like you to think about how you're going to compensate this old fella in future." She's just going, "Thank you very much. Yep, I'll go to jail and I'll think about it. And I'll send him a letter. That'll be compensation enough." But you see, here, if the shame of it all, she'll probably go out of her way to get him all paid back. But, I mean, she's got 8 years. 8 years. And they were pushing for 13. 13 years for taking advantage of three stupid fucks in the 50s. She needs giving a round of applause. And you need to be locking up these three fellas for giving a fella like me in his 50s a bad name. Fucking gullible fucks. Is a European man in his 50s going to be taken like this? I'm not so sure. Unless you're a bit of a retard. Unless you've got... You're not dealing from a full deck. You know, is anybody going to get any money out of me? I went to a Burnley game. And this cricket ground is next door stadium. So we parked up in the car park at the cricket ground. And as we're going in, it were a fiver. So I give the fella a tenner. And he gave me my change back. And I looked. And he'd only given me 4 quid. And I said, "You've only given me 4 quid. And he went, "Look, move on." I said, "You've only given me 4 quid. Move, move." And then another bigger fella came out. He said, "Look, get it out with his queue." So I drove down, parked up, and I went back to get my fucking quid back. And then when I'm asking for my quid back, I'm surrounded by about 4 or 5 gypsies. Big, I mean, I don't even think they were supposed to be taking money for parking on that car park. I think they just racked up with a sign and people came in and parked. Because where we were parking, on the grass of the cricket pitch. It wasn't a car park. So I think there were just some gypsy chances. Now, that was over a month and a half ago. And I still think about that fucking pound that them gypos did me at her a month and a half later. And it angers me. A quid. A fucking quid. $1.50. 200 yen. I'm annoyed that I were done out of a quid in Burnley before I went to a football game, in which I got a free ticket for. I got 2 free tickets at Burnley game. Yet, I were done out of a quid at car park. And I'm still thinking about that quid. I think it's easy to understand. You're not even going to be getting 10,000 yen from me at one of these hostess bars. Never mind 155 million. 155 million. If you are one of these fellas and you've been robbed or swindled, or so you think you've been swindled. I don't think they've been swindled. I just think they've been fucking stupid. You know, there's a thin line. Have you been swindled, or are you just fucking stupid? Or is it just, do they both go hand in hand? I don't know. I don't know. But I don't think she deserves 8 years. I don't think she deserves 8 years at all. I think she deserves a round of applause. I would have made her pay the money back. Because, I mean, if she could do it in 6 months, I'm sure she could raise that money again in a year and a half. Because she's famous now. I think fellas would want to go to the hostess bar where she worked just to see, you know, just to see what it is to have a date with her. And I think she would have made millions that shouldn't be locking her up. But she's going to have to sit and think about it for the next 8 years. She's going to have to pay that money back and just think about it. To get that amount of money, which I don't have, out of me, would be a long shot. Now, I'm thinking these three fellas are the only three fellas that have come forward, because there must have been more. There must have been more. But I think the three fellas that have come forward will be one single, they won't have a girlfriend, they won't have kids. So that's how they've got their hands on this much money. And I think if you're getting swindled out of 10, 20 million yen and you're married, I think that's a different matter. You want to be keeping that on the lowdown. If your wife knows that you've fucking blown 10 million yen on a hostess, that's your marriage fucking done. That's you paying child maintenance. That's you having to pay for the house to live in. So I think you would just write off that 10 million yen. But Jesus Christ. These three fellas have probably got no chance of getting the money back. And you've got a fella in Tokyo that looks like this goth. Like I say, I'll put another photo. I'll put a photo of him up as well. But he looks like this goth. And I'm thinking, if the money that I paid this woman, if one fucking yen of it were going to him, I'd have to hunt that fucker down and break his nose or something like that. Because he just looks like this fucking dweeb who has been here to convince this woman to make all this money for him. And she's just handed it over. The kicker to this thing is she got caught. And she got caught because she wrote a book. She wrote a book about it. How to swindle men out of money. How to get money out of older men. That's the loose translation of the book she wrote. And it's been quite popular. I mean, she has let the cat out of the bag now. So much so that another woman in Nagoya has been up in front of the judge in the courts in Nagoya. And she swindled 10 million yen out of one fella in a matter of weeks by just using this book. Now, who knows how many women have got this book in their hands now and are slowly working through the chapters to get money out of men across Japan. She made 41 million yen just through selling this book. And another charge that they've got her up on is failure to pay tax. So she's sold, I don't know how many books you have to sell online to make 41 million yen, but it must be a fair bit. So those books are out there. However many books they've gone out there, those books are out there in young, attractive women that don't want to go to university, that don't want to get a job in a supermarket or in a coffee shop. They just want to go to an hostess bar and make millions and millions a night. So those books are out there, and the first arrest has been made, and this woman in her defence said, well, I read this book and I did everything she said and I made 10 million in a matter of weeks. A woman like this is now doing 8 years, where she shouldn't be doing a single day. In my mind, she shouldn't be doing a single day. But there you go. I will put a link in the description, which will take you to the story. You can write me back in the comments, you can direct message me and tell me what you think. Should she have been locked up? Should she be let out? She shouldn't even be in prison in the first place. Now, as much as I love the way this woman has made money, I wouldn't want my daughter making money like this. No, I would want my daughter working in a supermarket or a coffee shop. I don't want her working in places like this. And I think because half of her DNA is Yorkshire, she's not handing a fucking penny over to him, any fella, if she's earned that money. I think that's born deep when you're from Yorkshire. I've earned the money, you can go fuck yourself. Anyway, that's that and that's that. Don't go spending your money on hookers half your age. A wise man has spoken.
Casserole with